Hi guys, you are all once again welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today too, we are here to look at another spoilers on Jada Akbar. But before we start, like we always do, look on your screen, you will see this on it. Click on it, subscribe to the channel so that the next videos you'll be the first person to see them and then watch them. Now that you are done subscribing, let's start. So today we are here to look at how the whole palace got to know about Jada's pregnancy and how they prepared towards that, and then also look at how Shinaz was exposed, how her true identity came out, and everybody got to know that this is Shinaz, her mom, and then her intentions, and how Jala nearly what killed Tudama because he ordered for his sentence. He ordered that they should sentence him to death because Shinaz trapped him and then put rape case against him. So that's what we are coming to look at today, what will happen or what we expect on that particular scene. So this is a spoiler we are bringing to you so that you get to know, as you watch them you get to know things ahead. This very spoiler will happen in this month, August. It will happen coming August. So let's start with Jada's pregnancy. So Jada received a news from the doctor that she's pregnant. Rukia becomes aware of Jada's pregnancy. On one side, there are preparations for Jada's unborn child ceremony, and the other side, Mahachukchak has sent Kaiba to kill Jala. Mahan fears that Shinaz might reveal her truth to everyone. The doctor states that Jada is expecting twins. Celebrations are ongoing within the palace. Meanwhile, Kaiba is causing a big havoc outside the palace. Kaiba kidnaps Jada. Jala holds Zakira responsible for the poison. Tuda sees liquid burn on Shinaz's hand. Mahan brings Adam to her secret place where Chand is. Tuda suspects Shinaz and begins to follow her everywhere. So here, the reason why we are saying that Jala holds Zakira responsible is because Tuda suspected that everything going on, because on the celebration day, which Jala asked all the wives to prepare a special gift for the king, Jada prepared a crown for Jala, and then Shinaz placed in what poison. So for the first time, when Jala was coming to wear the crown, Tudama stopped him because he noticed there's a poison in the crown. So they are now looking for the person, and then the first suspects is what Zakira, because Zakira worked with Benezel, and Benezel we all know was what very prisoner. So she was the first person who was what suspect, and then they put her in prison. But later on, Tudama also seized the liquid on Shinaz's hand and then suspected her, and then started to follow all her moves. So let's continue. Shinaz think that I have to go in Jale's room to find about the way to my mother, and also I can get treasure map. Shinaz goes toward Jale's room. Tuda follows her. She comes to his room, but soldiers stop her. She thinks how to go in. She sneakily goes in. Tuda sees it. Shinaz go in Jale's room from window. Tuda follows her in. One does he sees him going and thinks, why is he going like this in Jale's room? So here, what you have to expect. So Tudama saw Shinaz going to Jale's room and decided to what follow her up and then see what she's up to. And then when he caught her, Shinaz decided to what play a trick on Tudama, because she knows that definitely Tudama is going to expose her. So definitely she must do something which will cause havoc or which will cause doubts in Jala and Jada's mind. And then let's continue. So Jala says, I'm praising you and you are seeing this. So Jala was praising Jada. They listen to someone crying and comes to see. Jada and Jala comes to Shinaz, who is crying incoherently. Jala is shocked to see her clothes being torn. Jala asks, what happened, Shinaz? Jada drove sure around here. Shinaz says, he beat me, he molested me, he was assaulting me. Jala asks, who was he? She says, the one who is always with you, the fair color. She cried. Jala orders to bring all man in what court. So definitely she's going to put all the blame on Tudama, because she knows that Tudama saw her and now knows her intention. Tuda knows that she's normal and she's only pretending. So she has to play this trick so that Jala will doubt Tudama. So that's what she did. And then, so let's continue. So Jala and Jordan. So on the next episode, now let me say this. When Jala heard that Tuda raped Shinas, Jala doubted it because he really trusts Tudama. But here's the case. The reason why Jala ordered for today's sentence is because Jordan was defending Shinas. Anything Jala will say, she will never agree, but she thinks that definitely it's Tudama who did that. Meanwhile, Jala also trusts Tudama that Tudama can do anything like that. So after everything, fast forward, Jordan Begum sleeping. We saw Jordan sleeping, but she recollects about the storm last night. She wakes up immediately and lighting the lamp near Lord Krishna, but the lamp doesn't get lightened up. She prays to the Lord, requesting not to let anything wrong happen. Jordan Begum does worship of holy basil tree. Later, she goes to meet Jala to give him the offertory. While she tries to talk to him, he continues with the practice, avoiding her. A servant comes there informing that it is the time for the punishment of Tudama. So when Jala ordered for Tudama's sentence, he was troubled because he knows that definitely he's going to kill an innocent man, but he has nothing to do because all the evidence goes against Tudama. So he was very troubled, and then Jordan also noticed that. Okay, so Jala gets upset as he's feeling very guilty. Jordan Begum also feels guilty, but she doesn't understand the reason behind her feeling. She trusts Lord Krishna. She goes to meet Shinas. In the next scene, Maham and Adam are happy to create misunderstanding between Jala and Jordan. Because of this same issue, Maham and Adam took advantage of it, because now Jala trusts Tudama, and then Jordan also trusts Shinas. So that brought the misunderstanding between the two. So in the next scene, Zakria feels very sad as Tudama is being punished. She asks him to trust God. Tudama is ready to get punished, but he wants Shinas' real face to be exposed. Jala is also feeling uneasy after announcing the punishment for Tudama. He prays to God to show him the right path. Jordan comes to Shinas' chamber and hears her uttering that she has to act like a mad all the time. Whenever people are present around her, Jordan slaps Shinas. Jordan goes to her and slaps her repeatedly. Shinas again tries to do the same drama, but Jordan Begum gives her a tight slap. Shinas holds her hand and reveals her real identity. She ties Jordan Begum's hands. Jordan asks her for her intention. Shinas tells her that she is the daughter of Chand. She is the daughter of Chand Begum's daughter and Jala's elder sister. Jordan Begum gets shattered to know that. Shinas shares that Jala had made Chand Begum in a deteriorating situation. So she's trying to say that now Jala is the person who has kidnapped her mom. Meanwhile, she doesn't know the one she's supporting, which is Maham, is the one who is keeping her mom. So Jordan Begum tries to clear her misunderstanding, but Shinas ties her legs and cover her mouth. So Jordan was trying to explain to her that Jala doesn't know anything about it. So Jordan Begum tries to get herself released, but she cannot. In the next scene, Rahim comes to Jala informing that Shinas has destroyed his toys. Jala wonders to see the toys. He goes to talk to Shinas, but he gets shocked to see Jordan Begum tied by Shinas. He gets angry on her. Shinas blames Jala for everything that has happened. Jordan Begum reveals to him that she is Shinas, who is the daughter of Chand Begum. So now Jala knows. So Jala is shocked to know that Shinas is his sister. Shinas says that she has now found out the location where her mother has been kept, and she will get her release. She also shows him the order of his father. Jala tries to explain to her that she was not aware about anything that she is talking about. Shinas also revealed that she added poison to his crown. She pushes Jordan Begum towards him and runs from there. Jordan asks Jala to make Shinas clear that he is not her enemy, but Shinas kidnaps Rahim and tries to run away. On the other hand, Tudama is taken for the punishment of death. Adiga also feels sad for the scene. Shinas throws Rahim downstairs and gets on a horse to ride away. Jordan Begum asks Jala to stop the punishment of Tudama. Jala runs to save Tudama. While Tudama is about to get punishment, he prays to the Lord for the truth, asking him to take care of Jala. His wife Omila gets very emotional. Tudama also feels sad as he cannot accompany his wife to the end of her life. But fortunately, Jala arrives there and saves Tudama. He orders the guards to release Tudama. Tudama's wife hugs Tudama. Jala apologizes to him and offers him back his sword. Jordan Begum also apologizes to Tudama, but his wife appreciates her for her intention and thoughts with her respect. So Mahan took Cha has sent Kaiba to kill Chala. Mahan fears that Shinas might reveal her truth to everyone. Mahan took Cha has sent Kaiba to kill Jala. Adam requests for a province to rule over. Shinas realizes Mahatucha has been using her as a pawn. So this is what this particular spoiler has for us. So like I said, try and subscribe to the channel because there are more spoilers on the way coming, so that you'll be the first person to get them and then watch them. See you soon.